Hey YouTube, what's going on? Ryan Knows Tech here from TechInform.us, and here I've got a video by request of the iPhone 4, yes, have it a day early, and the iPod Touch 3rd generation. This happens to be the 64 gig, just for clarification. It's not the 8 gig, which is really 2G. They're essentially not really the same hardware at all. I mean, the iPhone 3GS and the 3rd generation Touch here on the right were really the same hardware. Essentially. And now the iPhone 4 brings a completely new case, 512 megabytes of RAM versus 256 over here, and a 1 gigahertz, we think, Apple A4 processor versus the 800 megahertz Samsung ARM 11 processor. So we're going to do a couple tests here, one of which involves logging in and shutting down eventually. They're both running iOS 4 right now, which is, of course, the latest version of Apple's operating system. Now, this camera, unfortunately, cannot focus very well up close at all, but that is the Retina display on the new one, which is 4x the resolution. And you really can't see much of a difference, mainly because of the camera. Now, we're going to turn them both off here, do a little reboot test. They all have the same applications, the same music, the same pictures, and the same videos on them, so I think it is rather fair. I'll hold them so you don't get too much of a glare. Looks like the iPhone's taking longer to shut off. I will say I had a couple more applications open on the iPhone than I did on the Touch. Anybody wondering? I have already sold the iPod. Okay, we're going to boot up here. Well, they both boot up. I'll say that, of course, the iPhone is a phone, a compass, it has the gyroscope, the better case, a front-facing camera, and a rear-facing camera. So it has all of that over the iPod Touch, as well as the better display and faster hardware. And the next iPod Touch is going to be a much better comparison to this device than this is, but just by request, I figured I'd honor it. Alright, looks like the iPod Touch was here just a hair ahead. Go ahead and log in. And might as well do a little speaker test. I always get asked about that. Opening up music. Looks like the iPod Touch won there as well. We're not going to do anything online because my power is actually out right now. And I don't have fast 3G and I don't have anything on the iPod. So, let's see, a song where I'm not going to get in trouble. Well, we'll play a couple seconds of Thriller. We'll listen to the iPhone first on full volume. Speakers down here, and the microphones over here. Alright, so it's relatively loud. I think it's definitely louder than the iPod Touch, even just with one smaller speaker there. Alright, that probably goes over my 20-second limit. Here we are with the iPod Touch. So it's definitely quieter. Definitely quieter. I think that still sounds decent, definitely usable, but just a little quieter than the iPhone. So as far as performance, they both seem to be very good. We'll go ahead and open a larger application here. Why won't that go away? How about Asphalt 5? I'll probably let the video play. So they're both very quick in launching applications. Now, since the iPhone 4 has more RAM, It's going to do a better job in multitasking since more applications can be open. And it will be quicker. The camera on here, I'll touch on that, it's very good. Obviously the iPod Touch does not have one as of this generation. So the differences between the device, they're really not fit for that well of a comparison. 800 megahertz, a gigahertz, Samsung processor, Apple processor, 512 megs of RAM, 256. You're going to be able to buy a 8 gigabyte iPod Touch, which is a 2G, and then the third generation, 32 and 64, while the iPhone comes in 16 and 32 gig capacities in both black and white. So if I can get my hands on a fourth generation iPod Touch, we'll definitely put these two back next to each other and talk then. But really, the iPhone, it feels faster. Some of these tests here, it was just a second behind. I don't know why, honestly. But both are great devices, and right now, I think you're better off getting an iPhone 4, because I love it. So thanks a lot for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe if you like the content. My website is techinform.us. My Twitter is twitter.com/JamesRSchultz. And every Tuesday night between 7 and 9 p.m. Eastern Time, we host our live web shows. So hopefully we'll see you there or in tomorrow's iPhone-related video. Bye-bye. Thought I'd go ahead and mention physical dimensions. I forgot to touch on that. The iPhone is a little bit taller, and it's actually a little bit thinner, shorter. It is slightly thicker, but not much at all. It's not a contoured design like the iPod Touch, so it feels a little heavier, because it is heavier. But it's a fantastic device, both of them are. Put them on top here. You can see that both are very thin, but the iPhone is, of course, a little bit thicker, packing all that extra stuff in there. Sorry, the lighting is not the best for this. And then it is, the iPod Touch is longer, or the iPhone is longer and thinner.